This video is going to be about solving a word problem using scientific notation. So here's the problem. I'm going to start out with a basic fact. 1 pound of gold is worth approximately 2.3 times 10 to the fourth dollars. And let's say that I've got $3 billion and I want to convert that into gold. And I'm curious how much it's going to weigh. So the first step is going to be to take that $3 billion and convert it into scientific notation. I'm going to do that in two steps. First, I'll write the $3 billion with all its zeros. So that's going to be 3 followed by 9 zeros. And then, of course, that means in scientific notation, it would be 3 times 10 to the ninth. I'll put a dollar sign in front of that. So I want to convert that into gold. I want to know how many pounds of gold. So it's going to be X pounds. And those X pounds are going to be worth 3 times 10 to the ninth. Okay, so what have I got here? It's two equations. In both equations, I've got pounds on one side and dollars on the other side. And if I take any equation and I take the numerator, I take the left side of the equation and call that a numerator and the right side and call it a denominator, that fraction that results is going to be equal to 1 because I've got the same thing in the numerator and the denominator. So let's make two fractions. The first fraction is going to be 1 pound over 2.3 times 10 to the fourth. That's the fact I started with. And the second fraction is also going to have pounds in the numerator. That's going to be X pounds. And that's going to be over the dollar value, which is 3 times 10 to the ninth. Now look what I have here. Both of these fractions, which I've set equal to each other, have pounds in the numerators and dollars in the denominators. In other words, I'm using the same units for the numerators and then the same units for the denominators. And now I want to find out what X is. So what I can do is multiply both sides by 3 times 10 to the ninth. Well, 1 pound, I'm going to have 1 pound times 3 times 10 to the ninth, that's dollars, over 2.3 times 10 to the fourth dollars. And on the right side of the equation, well, that 3 times 10 to the ninth dollars would just have canceled. So that's X pounds. X pounds. Now this looks kind of clumsy, but it's going to cancel out very nicely. You notice I have a dollar sign in the numerator and the denominator of this left-hand fraction. Well, I'm going to divide both of these numbers, both the numerator and the denominator, by dollars, which means I'm going to cancel out my dollars. I've got a pound sign on the left side of the equation and on the right side of the equation, so I'm going to divide both sides of the equation by the pound sign. So I'll cancel out my pound signs. And now what I've got, I'm just going to rewrite this, is the X all by itself, and X equals, let's see, 3 times 10 to the ninth over 2.3 times 10 to the fourth. I've gotten rid of all my units. And what I want to do is take this fraction and convert it into a single number in scientific notation rather than a fraction. So that means I've got to take the 3 and divide it by 2.3. So let's do that down here. 2.3 divided into 3. I can move my decimal point over and make that the same as 23 divided into 30. 23 into 30 goes one time. 1 times 23 is 23. I subtract, I get a 7. I bring down a 0. 23 into 70 goes 3 times. And 3 times 23 is 69. I've got a remainder of 1. I could keep doing this, but since I was dealing with an approximate value of gold, I think I'll stop here and call that 1.3. So now I can take that fraction and turn that into 1.3 times some power of 10. And let's see, the power of 10 will be, I've got 10 to the 9th in the numerator, 10 to the 4th in the denominator. So I'll subtract that 4 from the 9 and get 10 to the 5th. So the weight of my gold, my $3 billion worth of gold, is going to be 1.3 times 10 to the 5th. And the unit I was dealing with, let's see, what was that, is pounds. Okay, so let's just convert that into a number that we're more used to seeing. It's a standard form. So I'll take the 1. I've got 1.3. I'll take the 1. After the 1, I would want 5 decimal places. So the first place will be taken up with the 3. And then I need 4 more places. I'll put those in with zeros. So my $3 billion is going to weigh 130,000 pounds. Okay, let's just go over the steps one more time. When you're dealing with word problems like this, you've got to start out with some basic conversion fact. In other words, you've got to know, you've got two different kinds of units. I've got pounds of gold and I've got dollars, and you have to know how they equate to each other. So we're going to start out with that fact. The 1 pound of gold is 2.3 times 10 to the fourth dollars. That's my first equation. My second equation is going to be, it's going to involve an X, the thing I'm looking for, and what I know about it. So what I knew about my problem was that I had $3 billion. So I converted the $3 billion into scientific notation, and I said that X equaled that amount, or X pounds equaled that amount. Then I set up two fractions. Both of the fractions are equal to 1, because I used the numerator of my first equation over the denominator of that equation, and that was equal to the numerator of the second equation over the denominator of the second equation. Now I've got two fractions, both of them equal to 1, and I've made them equal to each other. And now I'm just solving for the one unknown I have, which is X. It looks a little sloppy because I've got all these units, but the units cancel out. I end up with a value for X, and then I take that, if it's in a fraction form, and I simplify it into scientific notation form without a fraction. And then if I want, I convert that into standard form. Okay, so that's basically the process. Take care. I'll see you next time.